Today's topic is stability, and in particular, how to evaluate the thermal stability of a bipolar transistor bias network. Let's start right away considering a common emitter stage. You should know that the collector current is equal to the base current times beta. However, as we are doing an in-depth analysis, we should consider leakage currents as well, and in particular ICP0, that is the reverse leakage current from the collector to the base. This contributes to the collector current as follows. ICP0 is usually very low, however, some problems could arise since it is very strongly temperature dependent. ICP0 approximately doubles every 10 degrees of temperature increase. Where's the problem? Well, if for any reason the transistor temperature increases, ICP0 will increase as well. This will lead to an increase of the collector current, which will cause an increase of the temperature, which will cause an increase of ICP0, which will cause... and you can see where this is going. And thermal runaway is just behind the corner. In order to evaluate the thermal stability, we can define the stability factor S. This accounts for how much IC will increase with an increase of ICP0. So ideally, we'd like a very low stability factor. Reconsidering the expression of IC, we can perform a derivative with respect to IC. This allows us to derive a more comfortable expression of S to work with. We just need to compute the variation of IB with respect to IC. Let's start with the classic bias network, the fixed one, and let's compute the stability factor by computing first the variation of IB over IC. This is actually trivial, there's no dependency of IB with respect to IC. No matter what happens to IC, IB will always be VDD minus VBE over RB. Thus, our stability factor S will be simply 1 plus beta. And obviously, this is not good. So let's discard this circuit and try to analyze this configuration here, which seems more promising. By just looking at it, we can understand why. If IC increases for any reason, there will be an increased voltage drop on RC, and thus a decrease of the base current, which should stabilize back the collector current. Let's confirm our theory with math. With some basic calculations, we can express IB as visible. We can then do the derivative with respect to IC, which will give us minus RC over RC plus RB. If we plug this result in the stability factor expression, we can find this, which is less than the beta plus 1 we found before, so this circuit is effectively more stable with respect to the fixed bias, and we can improve the stability by increasing the value of RC. However, if our collector load has a very low impedance, S increases and in the limit case it reaches the previous ugly beta plus 1 value, so we might need a better bias network. And here it is, you've probably already seen it in plenty of circuits. If we consider the DC point using Thevenin's theorem, we can redraw the circuit like this, where VBB is the equivalent voltage, simply equal to the voltage given by the R1 and R2 voltage divider, and RB is the parallel between the two. A simple analysis will tell us that we can express VBB as this, from which we can apply the usual derivative of IB over IC, which, without losing too much time, gives out this result here. With another couple passages, we can express it also like this. We can now see how this time there is no dependency of the stability factor with respect to the collector resistor, so we can use any load in our stage without affecting thermal stability. If we use a very low RB, meaning low R1 and R2, in the limit case, S goes as low as 0. But obviously, the side effect is the increased power dissipation in the bias network. Last quick considerations. What about the instability given by the base emitter voltage? The latter usually decreases with a rate of minus 2.5 millivolts per degree, meaning that when the transistor temperature increases, the base emitter voltage drop decreases, leading to an increment of the base current, which could cause once again thermal runaway. Fortunately, our last bias network is well protected from this form of instability as well, since an increase of IC and thus of the emitter current will increase the voltage drop on the emitter resistor, thus balancing out the decrease of the junction voltage drop and stabilizing back the collector current. We can prove it once again mathematically by defining a second stability factor, called S', which accounts for the variation of the collector current with respect to the base emitter voltage variation. With some math, it is possible to express VBE as here, and then express S' as a function of S. This shows that by improving the stability factor S, we can also improve the stability S'. And in a nutshell, that's why you should never use a fixed bias network.